We are continuing with the exercise and we come to sum number 2, which says simplify. Again here, A and B is for homework. The other 6 sums, remaining sums are being done by you as C, D, E, F, G and H. So now we are doing subtraction. First we were doing addition, now we are going to do subtraction. So simple sum, 5 upon 4 minus 3 upon 8. First I find the LCM of 4 and 8. 2 2's are 4, 2 4's are 8. 2 1's are 2, 2 2's are 4. And again by 2, 1 1. So what LCM do I get? 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8. The method is exactly the same for addition and subtraction. In one you add, in the other you subtract. 4 goes into 8 2 times, so 5 has to be multiplied by 2. 8 goes into 8 1 time, so 3 has to be multiplied by 1. 5 2's are 10 minus 3 1's are 3. And 10 minus 3 is 7 upon 8. It's a proper fraction, it cannot be reduced to its lowest term, because 7 is a prime number, it will be divisible only by itself and number 1. So that's for sum number 2C. Now we move to 2D. So D I have 1 3 upon 7 minus 5 upon 20. First I change this mixed fraction to an improper fraction. So 7 upon 7 and 3, 10 upon 7 minus 5 upon 28 remains as it is. I find the LCM of 7 and 28. 28 is divisible by 2. So 2, 7 comes down, 2 1's are 2, 2 4's are 8. Again divisible by 2, 7 comes down, 2 7's are 14. And last 7, 1, 1. 2 2's are 4. 4 7's are 20. So my LCM is 28. 7 goes into 28 4 times. So this 10 has to be multiplied by 4. 28 goes into 28 only 1 time. So 5 will be multiplied by 1. 10 4's are 40 minus 5 1's are 5. 40 minus 5 gives me 30. Upon 28. Now can it be reduced? 28 and 35, not by 2, not by 3. 5 by 7 is 35, but not 28. Next, 7. Will 7 divide both of them? Yes, 7 5s are 35, 7 4s are 28. Now this 5 upon 4 can be converted to a mixed fraction. 4 goes into 5 once, remainder 1. So my answer 1, 1 upon 4. Let's go to part E. Part E says 7 3 upon 5 subtract 4 2 upon 3. Change the mixed fraction to an improper fraction. 5 7 is 35 and 3 38 upon 5. Subtract 3 4s are 12 and 2, 14 upon 3. Now I will find the LCM of 5 and 3. The more you do these sums, the better you will become at solving them. So try to practice as many sums as possible. I have said only 2 sums for homework. Make sure you do that diligently and wisely. And do all these sums in your notebook. Follow the instruction, follow the explanation, because as you do these sums again and again, you will understand the method. The methodology is the same for addition and subtraction. But the more we do these sums, the more 5 times, so 14 has to be multiplied by 5. 3 8s are 24, carry 2. 3 3s are 9, 10, 11, 140, minus. 5 4s are 20, carry 2. 5 1s are 5, and 2, 7. From 140, I have to take away 70. Suppose this is 100 and I took away 70, I would be left with 50. Correct? I would be left with 50. Add another 14. So it will become 64. See, 100 minus 70. I am looking at 120. 100 minus 70 gives me 30. From 100, if I take away 70, it's easy. From 100, take away 70, you get 30. In that 30, you add another 14, it will become 44. So my remainder is 44 upon 50. Now I ask myself, can I reduce this to its lowest term? No, it cannot be reduced. Not by 2, not by 3, not by 4, not by 5. Because I have to find the factor that will divide both the numerator and denominator. There is no factor of 44 and 15 that will divide both of them. So I change into a mixed fraction. 15 goes into 44. How many times? 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30, 15 threes are 45. But this is 44. So 15 twos are 30. How much can I be remaining with? 14. So 2, 14 upon 5 is the answer. Now we go to part F. So a little difficult, a lot of calculations to be done. So 16, 21 upon 25. Subtract 15, 60 upon 75. Big numbers, but nothing to feel scared about. Big numbers, we all want to multiply and add. So now I have to multiply 16 by 25 and add 20. So 25 into 16. 6 5s are 30, carry 3. 6 2s are 12, 13, 14, 15. 1 5, cancel. 1 5 is 5, 1 2 is 7. So what do I get? 0. 5 and 5 is 10. And 2 and 1 3 is 1. 400 plus 21 gives me 421 upon 25. Subtract. 75 multiplied by 15. So 75 multiplied by 15. 5 5 is 25. Carry 2. 5 7 is 35. 36, 37. Cancel. 1 5 is 5. 1 7 is 7. 5 7 5 12. 7 3 10 1 11. 1125. In this, I have to add 60. So what do I do? 5. 6 into 8, 1, 1. So I get 1185 upon 75. I've run out of space, so I will do that. This is rough work, so I am erasing it. So, I have to find the LCM of 25 and 75. 2 doesn't go. 3 goes in 75. So, 3, 25. 3 2s are 6. 3 5s are 15. 25 is divisible only by 5. 5 5s are 25. 5 5s are 25. And 5 1s are 1. So, I get my LCM. 3 5s are 15, 15 5s are 75. 25 goes into 75 3 times. So 121 has to be multiplied by 3. 75 goes into 75 only 1 time. So 1185 has to be multiplied by 1. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12. 1263 minus 1185 into 1 will give me the same number, 1185. So now from 1263, I have to subtract 1185. cannot take away 5 from 3, so I borrow 1, this becomes 5. 13 take away 5 will give me 13 take away 5 will give me 8. Again borrow, 15 take away 8. 15 take away 8 gives me 7. So I get 78 upon 75. 78 upon 75. There's no common factor that will divide 78 and 75, so it cannot be reduced. So I will change that into a mixed fraction. 75 goes into 78, only one way, 75. 76, 77, 78. 3 is the remainder. So 1, 3 upon 75. Let's go to our next sum, and that is G. G is 5, 7 upon 20 minus 2, 9 upon 40. Again, big numbers. 20 into 5. 20 into 5 gives me 100. 100 plus 7, 107 upon 20. Minus 42's are 80. 80 plus 9, 89 upon 40. Now I have to find the LCM of 20 and 40. So what do I get? 2 tens are, 2 twenties are, again by 2, 2 fives are, 2 tens are, again by 2, 5 comes down, 2 fives are 10, and last 5, 1, 1. 2 twos are 4, 4 twos are 8, 8 fives are 14. So the LCM is 40. 20 goes to 40 2 times. So 107 has to be multiplied by 2. And 40 goes to 40 only 1 time. So 89 has to be multiplied by 1. 2 sevens are 14, carry 1. 2 zeros are 0, that 1 comes down. 2 ones are 214. Minus 89 ones are 89. So again, big numbers, you can always do it in rough to be sure. So 214 minus 89. I cannot take away 9 from 14, so I will borrow 1. It will become 14. This will become 0. This will borrow from here 1, it will become 10. Now 14 take away 9 is 5. 10 take away 8 is 2. And here remainder 1, so 1, 2, 5. To make sure that you have subtracted, you can add also 9 plus 5, 14, 18 and 2, 10 and 1, 11, 1 and 1, 2. So 125 upon 40 is my answer. 125, I'm writing it here. 125 upon 40. Again, I ask myself, can it be reduced to its lowest term? Yes, it can be reduced to its lowest term because 125 and 40 is divisible by 5. 5 twos are 10, carry 2, 5 fives are 25, 5 eights are 40. Now it cannot be reduced, so I change it to a mixed fraction. 8 goes into 25, 8 threes are 20, remainder 1. So my answer, 3, 1 upon 8. Last sum of the day, and that is sum H. H is 2, 5 upon 14